Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for big nothing team started to roll out the new incremental update for nothing phone 1, nothing phone 2 and nothing phone 2a. All of these devices have same changelog for this update. Here you can check I am using nothing OS 3.2 on my nothing phone 1 and I received this new 113 MB of new small incremental update. This update is rolled out few days ago. So today in this video, we are going to review new features and all the changes of this update on our Nothing Phone 1, and same changes were available for other two devices, that is Nothing Phone 2 and 2a. We also did performance test, and at the end of this video, I have done one announcement for Nothing Phone 1 users. So don't skip any part of this video, watch it until the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. After updating your device, if you check about device section, you will see Nothing OS 3.2 build number is updated as Space War 3.2 4th August 2025 for Nothing Phone 1, while for Nothing Phone 2a build number will be 15th August 2025 and for Nothing Phone 2 it's 25th August 2025. This is the same Android 15 build, but the major change of this update is new August 2025 security patches, which is available for Nothing Phone 1, while for Nothing Phone 2 and 2a got latest September security patches with this update. Now we will discuss the new features and the changes of this update, which are common for all of these three devices. First one is the pedometer and screen time widgets now got new share feature, which provides access to content of these widgets to your family members or friends or anyone to whom you share its link. If you long press on these widgets here in the shortcut menu, you'll get new share option. Just check mark the box and tap on start sharing. Next, tap on the share invite link. This will generate the link which can be shared to anyone via all share options like Bluetooth, WhatsApp, Chrome web link, etc. So whoever got the access of this link, he can take a look of your step counts and screen time. This is especially useful for parents to keep watch on their children's screen time and physical activities by checking pedometer counts. Next in the camera, videos or photos preview can be done via default new gallery application. Means whenever you shoot photos or videos and tap on this preview button, it will open that media in the new Nothing Gallery version 1.0.33. We already reviewed the new Nothing Gallery in the details. You can check that video from the iCard link. New Nothing Gallery have very nice user interface. By just swiping over photos or videos, you can access media details. It has new shortcuts at the bottom with new user interface, having three tabs. One is for all media. Second is folder-wise grouping of the media. And the last one is a quick search to find any media content with keywords. These are only few features of this update, but Nothing team done the major bug fixes in this build. The first one is team fixes the tile display error in the quick setting whenever we add new tiles or remove tiles from quick setting panel. Next, team have optimized the display of VoNR icon in the status bar, but in my Nothing Phone 1 VoNR call still not working for 5G networks of Airtel carrier, even though I have full 5G network coverage. Next, in the hotspot and tethering setting, you can easily manage connected devices to your hotspot. Team also fixed the issue of failing to block connected devices in the hotspot and tethering option. Next, if you are using smartwatches with these Nothing devices, battery usage is now optimized, means less battery drain will happen even if you are connected smartwatches with these devices. Some fixes has been done for interphone display issues for some applications like Instagram, Subito and other applications. Nothing team also resolved the issue of failing to open PDF applications in cloned applications. These are the common fixes for all the three Nothing devices, but Nothing Phone 2 got few other changes like shared widgets now supports more sticker types, while for Nothing Phone 2a team improved the stability of pop-up view windows. So these are some features and changes we received in this update. Along with this, the enhancement have been done for system stability and optimizations of system performance. As I don't have Nothing Phone 2 and 2A, I can't able to show its performance improvement, but on Nothing Phone 1, performance is really very good. Everything is running pretty smooth. I did Geekbench testing of this update and I got the score of 962 and 2917 for single and multi-core CPU performance tests. While for GPU graphics testing on OpenGL graphics API, results were 2321 and for Wukong graphics API scores was 2773. All of these scores are not outstanding in comparison with old version, it's almost same. But when I did the Antutu benchmark testing without performance mode, scores was 555,292. In Antutu benchmark, we can able to use Nothing game mode. So I enabled the performance mode using this setting and then again did the Antutu benchmark testing. And we got the score of 574,206. So the performance mode of Nothing game space really improves the performance and it boosted the scores by 18,900 points. I think Nothing should add separate performance mode setting for overall system like OnePlus did in their OxygenOS. So these are the new features and fixes common for Nothing Phone 1, Nothing Phone 2 and Nothing Phone 2A. All of these devices still didn't got Android 16 version of NothingOS. But in upcoming days for Nothing Phone 1, I am going to review exclusive Android 16 custom ROMs which are now available for this device. This is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to Nothing Phone updates and custom ROMs and GSI builds for any Android device. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.